Dear students, welcome to Mayura Virtual Academy. In this session, we will be learning about ListView. As the name suggests, ListView is, we will be taking one view, and the same view will be repeated a number of times. So, in order to have better reusability of the code, and if the scenarios is, if you want to display the same views with the different descriptions and the different the requirements, we will be using the ListViews. So, this is one such example, where we need to display the different types of the OS that the mobile devices supports. In this case, so this is, each one is one view, the Android is one view and iPhone is one view. Since we need to display the strings of the different OS that the mobile devices and the other system supports, we'll be using the one view and we'll be repeating that n number of times, so that we can use only the one view instead of creating n number of views. So that is the use of list view. So, as I explained earlier, the list view will group the several items and display them in the vertical scrollable list. So, we can display one view in n number of times. So, we use the adapter class that is provided by the Android system, so that what it will do is the adapter class will automatically insert the list items into the view and display in the vertical scrollable things. This adapter class will bridge the UI component and the data and fill the UI component and displays the view in the scrollable list. So it will be holding the data and it will be sending the data to the adapter view, and that view takes into the different, we can insert the view into the different formats. Either it can be only the strings in the list view, or it can have checkboxes in the list view, or we can display the same view in the grid format. So we'll be having the view and we'll be using the adapter to bridge the view and display it in the number of times that we require. So the Android provides various types of adapters. One such is array adapter. If our requirement is only to show the strings, as if this is the requirement, if we want to show only the strings in the vertical scrollable things, we'll be using array adapter. So here is a simple example to show how we can use an array adapter. Say in this scenario, we need to display the different strings. Here the strings is OS that the mobile devices supports. So we use the string array and we store all the strings that we need to display into the list view. So whenever the user clicks on the button, what we'll do is we'll create an instance of array adapter. This array adapter takes three parameters. One is the context from which we are creating. Other one is the layout that in where we need to display these strings or the list items, and what array that we need to pass, the data that we need to pass. The data is the array of strings. So this array of strings will be each string in the string array will be put up into this the layout, that is r.layout.activity.listView, and the same thing will be repeated for number of strings, the total number of strings that is present in the string array, and it will be displayed to the user as a list view. So we'll be creating the instance of list view. The list view will be having it will take the view as this, and this adapter will be setting the adapter. The adapter will bridge between the view and the data and display the list view to the user. This is how the array adapter works. The other one is other type of adapter that the Android system provides is simple cursor adapter. If our requirement is, if we want to show along with the string, if we have even the images need to be shown into the list view, we'll be using simple cursor adapter. Here, the cursor data will be mapped into the list view, into the list item, and the same item will be repeated number of times using this adapter. We'll be using the HMap to map between the data and the list items. Other type of adapter that Android system provides is cursor adapter. So if you have data that is stored in SQLite database, we can fetch the data from the SQLite database and we can display into the user as a list items. For the cursor adapter to work, the ID of the SQLite database should be underscore ID. If the ID is different than this, the cursor adapter cannot read the data and display into the list view. And along with this, for all these adapter, the cursor adapter or simple cursor adapter or array adapter, the base class is the base adapter. which Android provides. So other than these three, if we need any custom type of adapter, we can create our own custom type of adapter by extending the base adapter that is provided by the Android system. So it has got many inbuilt methods. So according to the requirement, we can override the methods that is present in the base adapter, and accordingly we can manage and display the items into the adapter. A few other adapters that is provided by the Android is spinner adapter. So if your requirement is you display the list items and you need to give an user a choice to select which item that the user needs, then we'll be going ahead with the spinner adapter. And the other type of adapter that Android system provides is expandable list adapter. So it will be displaying one is the parent, other one is the child. So in this case, we have list items of the various the articles. Whenever the user clicks on one particular thing, say science and news environment, its child items will be displayed. So in this case, the top one will be the parent items. On click of the parent items, the user can see the child items that is present inside the parent item. So whenever the user clicks on science and environment news, the sub child items present inside that parent will be displayed, and we can the user will be shown up with the child items. So this list view has got two methods. So whenever the user clicks on this an item click listener will be invoked, and according to that we can perform any operations that we require. And one more method that the list view provides is on long item click listener. Whenever the user long presses on a particular item, on long item click listener will be invoked, and according to that we can perform. So if the user clicks on that, we can navigate from this activity to other activity. So when the user clicks on long presses on particular item, either on the child or the parent, we can show the user that whether you need to close or whether you need to perform some other actions like pop up and alert dialogs. We can perform any other operations according to our requirement. So this is about adapters. Now let us take an example to learn how array adapters works, how simple cursor adapter works, similarly spinner adapter and expandable list adapter. We'll have a look at all these things and learn in detail through a simple application. Thank you. Have a great day.